So less than 200cc bikes are preferred by people for daily commute and for office purposes. And nowadays people want stylish bikes for office use. So Bajaj have done an amazing job by incorporating the wicked looks of Pulsar 200 NS into their 160 segment bike. And this is it, the new bike from Bajaj, that is the NS160. So let's roll the intro. What is up everyone and welcome to a brand new episode of Velocity Gear. This is Rahil back with another video, and in today's video I have this lovely 160 NS parked right in front of me, and I'm gonna have a nice little walk around and show you guys some details about the bike. So let's get started. Firstly, let's talk about the engine of the NS160. So according to the name itself, it has a 160cc engine, that is a DTSI twin spark engine. No, it does not get the triple spark technology which is seen in 200 NS, and this is an oil cooled engine, and this also has the underbelly pan just as seen in the NS. Engine produces 15.5 PS of power at 8000 RPM, 14.6 Newton meter of torque at 6500 RPM. And talking about the front disc brakes, it gets a slightly smaller disc brake, that is 240 mm disc brake. So let us now listen to the exhaust note of this bike. So it also consists of the underbelly exhaust system, and this is a BS4 compliant engine, which is very nice. So the bike also has the all-time headlight on feature, that is nowadays usually seen in new type of bikes. So according to the showroom only, the bike is available in grey colour variant. You can only get the bike in grey colour variant at the moment, and the pricing is around 97,000 on road. So the paint scheme is also similar to 200 NS. It consists of a combination of both gloss and matte colours, and this 160 on the side looks very elegant actually. Yeah. This is a very, very stylish offering from Bajaj. At the rear, there is no disc brake, it gets a drum brake, and there is no ABS in this vehicle. Whereas in the international market, single channel ABS is offered for the same NS160. That's a bit of a letdown actually. And seeing over here, there's a tire hugger which is similar to 200 NS, and you get also this extra foot holder which is not actually seen in NS200. Again, to make it suitable for the pillion rider. And the suspension is actually very well tuned for city purpose. I had a small ride in the city and it was very comfortable. The major plus point of this bike is the weight. The weight of the bike is incredibly low, that is 142 kgs. It felt very light and very comfortable during my little city ride. Talking about the instrument cluster, the instrument cluster is orange lit, whereas in the new 200 NS it's blue lit, and instrument cluster is also very, very impressive in this segment. And the tank also has the same 200 NS styling. It looks amazing, but this is a 12 liter tank, whereas the 200 NS gets a 13 liter tank. And overall the bike looks absolutely fantastic and very, very stylish for daily commute, and this is just amazing. So that was a small walk around video of 200 NS. If you guys have enjoyed this video, do hit the like and the subscribe button down below. Thanks for watching, and I'll catch you with the next one. Peace.